Everybody feeling good?
Yeah.
Real important to feel good. I woke up this morning, I was feeling good. So I called in healthy. Said, yeah, don't think I'm gonna be coming to work today. No, actually quite the opposite. I'm feeling good. Don't wanna come in there and ruin it. You know, because you're an asshole, and every time I come in there, I wanna kill myself. You know, so I got fired, which was fun. So I had to start feeling good again, so I started calling places I didn't work at and quitting. You guys ever done that? It's real fun. I call up TGI Fridays, I was like, I quit! I'm tired of living in the illusion. It's not Friday every day. I wish it was, we all wish it was, but it's not. And they're like, who is this? I'm like, exactly. But you gotta feel good, right? You guys know what I'm talking about, right? It gets sad out there sometimes, right, guys? And this guy knows what I'm talking about. He's like, yeah, it does. You guys ever get so depressed you go to Lowe's?
Yeah.
You just stand there? A young, nice young man, what's your name? Nice young man named John comes up. He's like, sir, can I help you? And you go, no, I'm exactly where I need to be. But thank you. I was trying to feel good again. No, I started, I did some yoga. We got any yoga people in here? Yeah. Everything was going really good until they called out child's pose, and I shit my pants. Didn't work out too well. That was cool. But hey, I'm feeling great because you guys are here. We got John Reep. Everybody give it up to John Reep. Yeah. I told my mom, I got to help with John Reep. You want your parents to be proud of you? You know what I'm talking about, right? Yeah. So I sent her a Facebook message. I was like, Mom, I get to help with John Reep. Sent her a video. She was like, wow, he's funny. You should be more like him. I was like, Mom, you've put me through enough therapy to know. You should have been more like his mom. Don't go there. Yeah. Live in the South. Give it up to the South. Yeah. Yes. Whoa. Like her. She put her hands in the air. That's awesome. Living in the South is pretty great. Except for the bigots. You guys know what I'm talking about? They're a little weird. Maybe not. I feel like it's good to have Southern pride, right? You want to have pride in things. But due to the history of the South, maybe it needs to be followed by a disclaimer, right? I love the South, because I love my great-great-grandma's cornbread whiskey biscuit recipe. Oh, you thought it was white supremacy in the incense. No, just biscuits for this film. Just biscuits. A lot of them like to sing songs about the South, which is great, you know, like, you can take the boy out of old Dixieland, but you'll never take old Dixie out the boy. Great song, Leonard Skinner. The only thing is, I'm pretty sure that means if you take the boy to New York City, he's still going to say racist things. Might be wrong, could be wrong. Dixie might be racist. Not sure. Maybe not. Maybe you guys are right. The weirdest bigots to me are the ones that fly the Confederate flag with the trucks. You know, good. You know, which I feel like would be weird without the racism, right? I feel like it'd be like if I had a Windows 95 flag, I put it on my Nissan Altima, go around like, woo! Windows 95! Never got any better than Windows 95. Who wants to come over and play Mom Sleeper? Yeah.
Windows 95!
But, you know, some of them, I grew up in Greer, South Carolina. A lot of the people that I met, the good old boys, yeah, Greer, woo, they were really proud to be dumb. I don't know if you met those guys. Like, I'm proud to be the dumbest son of a bitch you've ever met in your whole life. But at the same time, I believe my opinions matter and should be taken into consideration when contemplating every aspect of your life, or I will kick your ass. I don't really think that's how it works, right, guys? If you're dumb, you probably shouldn't say anything. You know what I mean? I got to this guy after a show, and I was in Clemson, South Carolina, and I had an argument. Go Tigers, big Tiger fan. I had an argument with this dude, and I was like, he was saying some racist stuff. I was like, dude, that's dumb, man. And he put me in a headlock, and he's like, who's dumb now, bitch? And I was like, dude, you are. You're still dumb. This hurts. You're kicking my ass, I'll give you that. I just want to know why being, like, kicking ass makes you tough, you know? I feel like if you're really tough, you can control your own emotions, right? If you're really tough, the thought of two dudes making out wouldn't make you want to shit your pants. If you're really tough, you wouldn't be so afraid of love. You know what I mean? A lot of dudes out there afraid of love. Are you going to fight love? Where are you at, love? You inside everybody in here? You omnipotent bitch. I don't even understand you. But I saw you 2 weeks ago under the moonlight. You were blowing through the trees. But then you just disappeared. Just like a bitch. Just like my daddy disappeared. Just like my daddy. Speaking of Clemson, South Carolina, love Clemson. Because, like, anytime you go to Clemson, you can just scream out, go Clemson. And no matter what anybody's doing in Clemson, South Carolina, they go, go Clemson! You guys see that? Go Tiger! C-L-E-M-S-O-N! You guys see that? It's hilarious. Exactly. I want to see how far I can take it, though. I want to have, like, sex with a frat dude's girlfriend. Like, bro, did you have sex with my girlfriend? I'm like, go Tigers! He's like, go Tigers. I thought she was the one. Awesome. All right, this is rocking and rolling. Damn it, I feel like I'm gonna have to end it there because my other set would be too far to go into. But sorry, I shouldn't have said that. That was me thinking out loud. Oh, you guys like impressions? Yeah. I'm gonna end it with a couple impressions, then I'm out of here. Right? You guys have been great. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. This first impression is of a mafia boss who just finds out he has food poisoning. Mafia boss, food poisoning. Hey, Nikki, you're not gonna believe this. You know Salmonelli? Yeah, he poisoned me. This is an impression of Tom Hanks' son being starstruck by Tom Hanks. Right? Dude, you're not gonna believe this. Tom Hanks called me. He asked me what I wanted for dinner tonight. All right, let's not do that. Well, there's more to it, but you guys didn't stop there. All right, my last impression. This is an impression of Jesus Christ. He's come back. This is him on a Sunday. First Sunday back. Jesus' first Sunday back, right? He's in the car with a friend. Wow, the church service is great today. It's really great. Yeah, it was awesome. I did feel the preacher was a little long-winded. But honestly, the whole time he was talking, I just kept thinking about those chicken biscuits from Chick-fil-A. Have you had one of those? Those are delicious. If you don't mind swinging by Chick-fil-A so they can get some, what do you mean it's closed? It's the middle of the day. Well, why do they close because of me? I love chicken biscuits. I want them open all the time. You guys have been a great audience. Thank you so much. Have a beautiful night. Good night for